beats the open country. The poetry of the wind crafting a rhyme on every tree and mountain. The applause of the leaves celebrating harmony. I won't find that in here. I'm done with this rat race. Wasting my best days sitting at a desk under fluorescent lights, swamped in paperwork. I don't know what happens tomorrow. But I do know I have my two hands and the open wilderness. I'm home, the open country.
Hey, what's up everybody? Xules here, and today I'm going to be taking a look at the game Open Country, which is available on PS4 and PS5. I'm playing this on the PS5 system. It's also available on PC through the Epic Store and Steam, and it's on Xbox as well. So this is an open world game with a huge open map where you can hunt, fish, drive ATVs, do all kinds of stuff. You even have an RTV, or an RTV, and they have an RV. You can't really drive it, but you can move it to certain locations and use stuff to store and camp in it. And so I just wanted to go over some of my tips to making this game a lot more enjoyable and easy to play.
In the game, your character has a set of skill points that they can level up. And it's pretty important that you start off right, and I didn't, because I didn't really realize until I watched some other people's videos, but there's a number of things that you'd want to do that would really help you in the beginning, and one of the things is the amount of stuff that you carry. So if you go and look through, you can do Heavy Sleeper, you can do Energize, and these are all great too, and then there's the increases of carry capacity. So I had actually leveled that up, which is good. And then the other thing is you want to use Energizer probably next, because it decreases the amount of overall energy, and I always have a lot of energy drain, and then Heavy Sleeper, which increases the amount of energy gained after you sleep. So all three of these are probably the most important skills to start off with. And I'm just saying that because it'll make it a lot easier to basically travel around, and your energy level and everything will be way better, and you'll be able to carry way more. So definitely things to consider when you're looking at the skill tree. The open world in Open Country is actually huge. So you start off on a map and you have a couple entry points, or one or two parking spaces, and you have to locate the other ones. So for instance, like if you walk all the way out here, you could find a couple other parking spaces on this map. And they were pretty far out here. There was one all the way down here, the South RV parking, which is nice because it's next to a river by the fishing. But you had to walk all the way over there. There's also another one up here somewhere. Where is it? Right here. So, and those were ones that you just located. I'm sure there's a bunch more as well, too. So that's pretty cool. It's like a discoverable. I mean, you really have to spend your time out here surviving and locate stuff. And then normally by the lakes, there's also a fishing boat. So you'll be able to go fishing as well. And there is one by the South RV parking. Your map is definitely your friend. You can access by pressing the middle pad on the PS4, PS5 controller, or the triangle button, and it's actually your first tab. You can see map, and you can also go in and out with R2 and L2, so you can actually zoom out a ways, and you can move all over the map, and you can also place markers by pressing R3, so you can add different things. Like say you're looking for a point of interest, a marker, food, whatever, you can label that, and then that will actually appear in your bar overhead. So it'll tell you which direction to go. So if I head northeast, that'll take me to the marker that I just placed. So it's a very cool way to make it easier to navigate the places, and then of course follow your compass. So yeah, that should definitely help you out as far as navigating around the map. Once you do get past, I believe, the second mission, you are able to buy stuff from Nancy Dean, the trader at the store.
When you are at the general store and you want to trade with Nancy, you are able to sell stuff directly from your RV. So that means you don't have to Use just your backpack. As you can see, press triangle and it will sell stuff from your RV. So we'll show the stuff in your RV as opposed to, just stuff that is in your backpack, which is cool. So you can have a number of stuff ready for listing and sale.
There are a number of items that I do recommend. One of the nice things about the consumables is that A, you can buy all your ammo here, and then you have all your health items, you can get your batteries. But the other thing is you have canned vegetables, and each time you come here, there's more available. So I buy them each time because they don't spoil. And that's one of the things you're going to run into with food, it spoils a lot. So if you just convert into canned, then you will always have food that is sustainable and not spoiled. And there's a couple items that are definitely stuff that you want to pick up. There's a couple repair things. There's also a large water bottle, which gives you two more drinks, which I highly recommend getting. You can get the sleeping bag or the tent, and the tent is awesome because you can place it anywhere. And you can see these are kind of pricey, but you can grind these out really quick and then just keep on returning to the store and selling her pellets and meat. And that's a good way to gain money so that you can buy this stuff basically, because you can sell the stuff from your resources right here. So as you can see, $21 per piece of meat. So that kind of adds up pretty quick. So now I'm up to 516. So it's a very good way to do it. One place it's good place to grind is just to go out to the Mellow Hills and this parking lot here. And there's always a bunch of stuff right around here. If you use your hunter sense, you can see there's berries over there, there's foxes, there's a bunch of stuff that you can just pretty much get right away. You can see the foxes over there too as well. So, and we'll try to hunt them. Oh, I missed him. But yeah, you get the gist. So you just go out here, kill a couple things, go back, sell them to her, and it's that simple. Well, I did get them. Okay, cool. And like I said, use the hunter sense to find more stuff. You don't need rocks, but berries are good. Anything that you can go and sell to her is nice. So pretty much any resource. She'll buy mushrooms, meat, hides. And that's kind of your bread and butter if you want to earn some money pretty quickly. Looks like I need a bit of water. I'm running this on the PS5 system, and I actually have it on the PS5's hard drive instead of on an external drive, so it runs a little bit better. But occasionally, there are crashes, mostly when returning to the lodge. One way to prevent this is to get the tent and then, of course, drop the tent or place it, I should say, like this, and then save your game before you head back to the main lodge because it crashes a lot when you do this, and I don't know why, and hopefully it's something they will address in the future and fix, but yeah, this is the one way that you can prevent this from happening. And now, when you return to lodge, if you do crash, you'll be right back at the tent. So, yes. Your RV in this game is sort of your lifeline. You can actually store a bunch of stuff and sleep in it as well, which is a good place to sleep. If you do interact with it, you can see there is a trunk and a fridge. So, you can store stuff. It keeps it a lot longer. And then your trunk gives you a number of spaces as well. So, this is a good place to store your stuff and sort of your home base to keep all your stuff. So, definitely a good thing to do. And then finding more RV parks so you can park closer to the areas is obviously very helpful. And there are RTV garages in this game where you can actually enter, and there's a series of races. I believe there's 10 ATV races that you're able to do, and you'll see them over on the racing billboard. And you can locate these on the map depending on which place you're at. And I don't know why it's showing me the map for that, and then this will give you the opportunity to race, actually. So there's actually races in open country. It's a racing circuit. There's no race creator yet, but maybe that's coming next. I don't know. That would be pretty cool, actually. And so this is an ATV race. You can see there's checkpoints and whatnot. And this is I believe this one's a short one, and the other ones are longer. I actually haven't found the other ones yet, and I will. This is a pretty cool game. I mean, there's a lot to do in this game, so. And this is sort of what you get with the racing circuit, the first RTV race that you find. I mean, it's a very short race, it's kind of a joke. But if you look at the other ones, they're definitely a lot longer, because there's one that even says it's over 10 minutes, so there's definitely some long ATV courses. And that's it for that race, so. As you can see, and you earn experience and bucks for doing that. So you can race over and over and actually earn experience, and then you could get more skills and stuff. So, yeah, pretty cool. I've only done a couple races, but definitely something to look into. There are a couple weapon upgrades you can purchase from the trader in the store, and you can equip the money weapons by going to your RV and then going to your weapons rack. And then going upgrade, and then it'll show that you have it, and you just simply press that, and then it shows that it's on there. So, yeah, pretty cool the way it works, and highly recommend upgrading your weapons, of course. And once you do equip it on your weapon, obviously you would just scope in, and you can see you've got a nice scope now. Yeah, pretty cool. Your water supply is obviously very important in this game, and anytime you're by a river, you're going to want to fill up your flask. I recommend getting the larger flask with 5 drink available, or whatever you want to call them. But like, yeah, so when you see a running river like this, it's going to be blue water, and so you're going to want to go ahead and press down on your D-pad, and then go ahead and fill up your flask. And that will give you blue water. If it turns out, and you look at the color, which shows right there, it's blue. If those bars are brown, and I'll show you right here, then you need to boil them. One of your most important things is your hunter sense, which is your L1 button. So you click that, you can see everything that is around you, which is very helpful. When you crouch down, you go into silent mode, which you do by pressing your right D-pad in, and this lets you crawl around silently so that animals won't detect you. And then, of course, you can use your hunter sense as well to locate stuff. If you're looking to gather some wood and resources to start a fire or build a camp, and you're using your hunter sense and you're not finding anything, you can actually equip the axe and go up to any tree and chop away, and it'll give you branches and logs. So there you go, branch stored in your backpack. And you know, it's just kind of random what it gives you. And then if you go hack away and like foliage, it'll give you leaves. So you can definitely gather stuff with your axe if you can't find anything using the hunter sense, which has fallen on the ground.
You can walk slowly by pressing down on your right joystick, and this will put you in a nice crouch mode. And you can also run by pressing on your left stick, but that will use up your stamina real quick and start eating into everything else. So don't recommend using it too much. You can see my stamina bar went way down from using it. And like most survival games, you do have a health bar, and that is down on your right side. You can see everything. You can see your temperature. As a matter of fact, I'm a little bit hot right now. and I'm a little bit low on food. I could eat a little bit. Water is full, and then of course I need to sleep. And then it also has a stamina bar, which is underneath that heart, and then the heart is actually your health. So those are all factors into the game, just like anything else. So if you eat something from your backpack, like beans, it'll fill up your health. So now my health is full. If I were to sleep, it will recharge my energy and so on. So just things to keep in mind, and there's definitely ways to manage this better and or worse for that matter. One tip is that you can gather animal hides, like this fox here, if you're crafting and looking to make rope, because rope is actually kind of hard to get. You have to find cloth, which is not something you can actually get from an animal or something, so you'd have to go around the map, and there's probably a limited supply. But you can actually create rope from small game using a knife and a small game pelt like this. So that is another helpful thing. So now we have rope, and that's just from animal hides. And I believe this is something that was added in the mix recently, because I've watched other videos where people had complained about not being able to craft rope.
You can gather live bait for fishing by simply picking up and dropping rocks near a river's bed, like so. And as you can see, one live bait stored. It's that simple. You just keep on doing it over and over. And most of the times you do get a live bait, so. Yeah, that's a pretty simple way to get live bait for fishing.
The boats themselves are pretty self-explanatory. Once you come up to them, you just press enter boat, and then you can do like normal. Your trigger, which is R2, is your acceleration, and then you can brake with L2, and so on. And then you can fish. If you don't have a fishing pole on you, which I don't, you can't fish, but you would be able to press X and start fishing, which is cool. Yeah, so that's kind of the boats, and you can navigate to the fishing spots, and I believe there's a set of missions that actually help you out doing this. So once you're by the dock to get off the boat, you just stop and press circle, and that will put you on the dock. And that's how you board the boat and use it. The game does have fishing boats as well, and you can find them mostly by the lakes. And if you explore, you will find a dock with a boat, and I found it on both maps that I'm able to access so far. I'm not able to do the winter one yet because I haven't passed the dog mission yet. So, because I've been exploring and doing other stuff, but as you can see right here, there is a dock which is actually by the South RV parking, which is way across this map. I mean, it starts you over here, the mountain, Mount Pass Cabin. So you really have to do some trekking to get all the way over to the other side here. And then along this river down here, there's the RV South parking. And then right here is where the dock is with the boat. All right, so that was my sort of beginner's definitive guide to open country. I hope you enjoyed this video. If I left anything out that you think I need to add, let me know in the comments, and I'd love to hear from you. And as always, thanks for checking out this video, and peace out, Igzulas.
Rush hour, the chaos of big city life. I can't even get a breath of fresh air anymore. With some room to move around. Lifeless buildings and skyscrapers everywhere. This is my home for most of the day. My cube. Nothing but cold numbers and paperwork. I feel trapped in a concrete jungle, and it's slowly draining the joy out of my life. I used to be happy and free. Nothing beats the open country. The poetry of the wind crafting a rhyme on every tree and mountain. The applause of the leaves celebrating harmony. I won't find that in here. I'm done with this rat race, wasting my best days sitting at a desk under fluorescent lights, swamped in paperwork. I don't know what happens tomorrow, But I do know I have my two hands and the open wilderness. I'm home, the open country.